go ahead and open the shopping cart database now that we know the status field says up and not provisioning. The first thing we need to do is set two configuration parameters. The offset reset should be set to earliest. This ensures that we will always return to the start of a Kafka topic when we run a new query. Next, we set the parameter ksql.streams.interval.milliseconds, which will configure to 3 seconds. This overwrites the default of 30 seconds, making our queries a bit more responsive. The first thing to do is to create a stream to hold our shopping cart events. The stream is materialized in a Kafka topic of the same name. So let's go ahead and run that statement. We can now see the output that confirms that the shopping cart event stream was created. We create 4 insert statements that push events into the shopping cart events topic. The first event adds 2 pairs of pants to the cart. The next adds a t-shirt. Then we remove one of the pairs of pants. Finally, we add a hat. So let's go ahead and run that query. Run the select statement. We should see 4 events returned. Indeed, we see 4 events were returned. We create the ksqlDB query that transforms the events into the summary table. To do this, we must include a sum on the quantity field with an associated group by that aggregates the events by item. The result will be a table that reflects how many items are in the shopping cart right now. So the removal should cancel the items we added. Now go ahead and run that query. There you go. Our current shopping cart summary table has been created. Run a query against the table just like you would query a regular database table. Select star from the current shopping cart, emitting changes. So we expect to see 3 records, not 4. 1 record per item, with only 1 pair of pants, as the 2 events for pants have been summarized into 1 row. That's what we see. There is 1 hat, 1 pair of pants, 1 t-shirt.
So in summary, whether your name is Sanjana or Bob, we simulate events coming from the user adding and removing items from their shopping cart. We store those events in a Kafka topic. We then created a streaming query to transform them into a table in ksqlDB. This all happens at write time. Finally, we query the summary table to get the contents of the shopping cart back to our application. And that's it. In the next module, we'll be discussing incorporating event storage into your system design.